very starting greed, then quickly becomes like, oh, super
dude,
aggression.
Don't
so.
Go jungle in your pups and blame me when you lose.
Yeah.
Because I said greed is good.
Is LC jungle good? I mean, that's as greedy as it gets, buddy.
I just remember it being a cheat code in the game. But I believe it might have been Age of Empires.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah. Warcraft 3, I think.
Warcraft 3? All right. There you go.
Help me. Save me from this man. All right. Hey, but...
Greed can be good at the right times. You have to know how greedy you can be. The balance is the one that's...
It's how you use that greed. You don't use the greed to keep on farming. You use the greed to go and take advantage of the fact, oh, I'm the strongest here. Like, a level 4 IO at 3 minutes or something, whatever he was, is, like, super strong.
Oh,
so
oh, the other way you use greed is you choose a game where you want to pick a lineup against an enemy. Like, for example, an alchemist, it forces your team to the enemy team to be always constantly to look to pressure you to kill you. Otherwise, it's like a ticking time bomb. That's the kind of game where you can choose.
Sure. Well, we won't be seeing any jungle aisle today.
Nope. And no fly warlock, so perhaps he will get the dazzle instead.
See, these two teams know about each other, man. I mean, that would be the first thing I'd ban out on Team OG. They really build those strategies around warlock lately, and it's a great ban against them. And I guess OG was pretty impressed by that Wisp play. No Slardar as well.
Warlock replacements would be like a Phoenix.
Phoenix and Winter Wyvern, I think, are the two fly heroes. But
I don't think he plays Winter Wyvern. But he plays Phoenix.
He plays a lot of Dazzle.
Yeah, but Dazzle isn't exactly the same kind of replacement. It's similar but different.
It but it depends on what plan they have as well.
Yeah, it depends on the plan.
And I think the big part of the Dazzle being a good first pick for Secret was because Slaughter was first pick. Like, it was very much like a response to the Slaughter as well, so... I'm not as sold on like a Dazzle like early on if you're not sure if your opponents are going physical damage.
Lone Druid is still in the pool.
Rose Spirit, okay.
Lone Druid has been picked up.
There you go.
There you go.
Ogre.
Oh, hey. Hello.
Ogre Sniper.
Ogre Sniper.
That's some VP opening right there.
Secret has a plan. That was no hesitation.
Yeah, well, they picked the old Sniper.
Who's the real Sniper now?
Yeah, exactly. But, I mean, that's not a bad answer to Lone Druid, right? You get a little Bloodlust on there and you're able to blow him up without having to move to the back lane, but isn't Lone Druid pretty good against Sniper? I mean,
both ways.
They're both good against each other. It's going to depend more on like the rest of the
heroes. But Sniper is more counterable than Lone Druid. Sniper has more weaknesses in general. Like.
And with the Earth Spirit picked up as well.
Gosh, this.
Oh,
I mean, that's a hero that can get right into Sniper's face, right?
See, that's,
that's not the main thing, you know. The main thing is who's playing the Earth Spirit. That's the main problem.
Right. The thing about OG.
Oh, yeah, but that just comes as an extra cherry on top.
They're such a difficult team to play against because you have so many people that you need to ban. Jarax can't get our spirit, or we lose. No Tail can't get anything, or we lose. It's such a difficult. You have
you're
such
going
a long
somewhere
list.
That point, and then your list includes Jarax's Earth Spirit.
I mean, that was it. If he gets Earth Spirit, you're done. If that's
Fly gets Warlock.
God. Yeah. Fly gets Warlock, you're done. Yeah. So, I mean.
You might see a Phoenix on Fly this game.
You think so?
They run Earth Spirit plus Phoenix a lot together in the past. And Phoenix with Lone Druid is pretty good because of the heal. When they focus the Lone Druid. Since you are going to be pretty tanky with all your stat items or Skadi at some point.
Both teams still need their like frontlining core, I guess. Something to just really stand in front, create space for the Sniper Lone Druid.
Clockwork will be pretty good for OG, I think, against the Sniper. Mm-hmm. And I know Gustav likes to play that hero.
Centaur is the other hero that really comes to mind.
Is
because
also good.
Sure.
Stampede to be able to get on top of be it Sniper or Lone Druid. It's better against the Sniper because Lone Druid has the Savage Roar, but it's still good for either team.
Yeah, I would have to agree with you on the Centaur. Really good answer to clearing that Sniper and deals with a lot of the problems that he has with that high damage to get an Ags.
And they ban out the Venge. I think Venge is also one of the better heroes to kill Lone Druid because of the swap.
Sure.
Swap him in and you just put him in a very vulnerable position.
So, Jake, you said previous game, or maybe you said, I'm not sure if you said it on camera or not,
I say
but
a lot
you
of
were
stuff.
Going to talk to S4 about how to set. Did he actually change his axe?
I hope so. I approached him after, I don't know if you guys noticed this, but he plays axe all the time, S4, and he uses, like, the almost vanilla axe. It's hideous.
Don't worry,
him and I asked
he's not
going
to play
axe
this game.
I don't think so. He actually thought I was shit-talking. He was like, I went up and I was like, you gotta change your axe. And he's like, who are you? Like, my axe is great. And I was like, no, the cosmetic. But sweet boy. He would never get upset. Sweet boy. Anyway.
For a second there, though.
Yeah, for a second, I was afraid.
That Swedish rage.
I saw the Swedish rage.
He's like, the guy who can only play Omni Knight is telling me my axe sucks.
Yeah, dude. It's scary stuff. But, alright, so LC banned down, huh? I guess that's a pretty good thing to jump on Sniper with, right? Especially the long forgotten LC Ags, huh?
Yeah, but if you look at their second ban, they ban out the Batrider because when they saw the Nyx and the LC ban, it's like setting up for a Batrider because those two heroes can counter the Batrider with the Carapace and.
Oh, of course, yeah.
And there was a lot of offlaners banned too, so now it's like, what offlaners are left, so you kind of...
Yeah, Kezu likes to play Batrider a lot.
Yeah. So, and now you're kind of like, that's where I think Secret grabbed the Sentinel first, because like, we need to make sure we get one of the few offlaners left. There is still the Clockwork you mentioned for OG, but I think at this point Secret are like, okay, let's make sure we
they
snag
could
something.
They choose Clockwork or Brewmaster, I think. Because I know OG runs the offlane Brewmaster.
Yeah.
Brew is pretty decent against Sniper.
Yeah.
But without like, I feel like the Brew's done had its most success in the offlane when it's like got a good dual lane. Like we've seen a lot of the Brew Coddle.
With
Earth Spirit, it seems
so
very weak.
Yeah. But Lone Druid safe lane, you don't need to protect him, so you can actually put.
Oh, put Fly in the offlane. Like
you can actually do Coddle plus a dual lane at bottom and Earth Spirit to roam and Lone Druid safe lane.
Lone Druid can 1v1 a Centaur. Just
That's why they actually ran the Io in the jungle in the previous game because it was a safe lane Lone Druid. You don't need much from your supports. Just so many benefits of picking Lone Druid, you know.
I mean, that's the problem, right? He can be anything that you want him to be, and you have to build an entire draft around countering one hero, and then it just opens you up for anything else.
Yep.
I mean, I think we saw it earlier in a series. Notel really didn't have that much of an impact on the Lone Druid, but they built an entire team to make sure that he couldn't have impact, and they still won, because they have to deal with all the other superstars on OG.
I mean, by the time that Lone Druid started to be scary, the game was already over.
The game was over. So
that helped. And he did say in the interview that you had with him that he thought that Lone Druid was dirty.
Yeah, he's a dirty.
They went for CM, so they're going to pick heroes that need mana. Like, that's going to use the aura very well. Like, Lone Druid doesn't need the aura.
And CM is not good against Sniper particularly.
Yeah,
or the
they
ogre.
Have a plan.
Not bad against Centaur because of the Frostbite, but not great either.
Yeah, they definitely have a plan right now.
So what big mana heroes might fit into this?
Not so sure right now, though, but...
Any
previously,
of,
they picked
Anna's
CM with Void. Anna's heroes.
We saw Storm Spirit earlier
today.
Storm
is pretty good against a Sniper and could use the Arcane Aura well. And that could be a good option. For Secret, they're looking for their position 5. Or maybe Highlight that could play the Ogre.
Yeah. Typically, it's actually Puppy playing like a very farm intensive Ogre. Like, he loves to buy Solo Crest. Great.
You saw him playing Tusk. Is this a Tusk game?
A Tusk with Ogre is not that great. I don't like the duo though, like Tusk, I'm not so sure about that.
Tusk would have a hard time. He would get in there, but he wouldn't be able to really blow anybody up, and escape with his life, I don't think.
Oh, hey!
Hey, the pilot! I die!
No,
Puppy
might be
playing
Puppy.
Lately,
it might be Puppy playing the hero. Ah, that's the mana hero.
Ah, there we go!
Yep. Yeah. The nerf.
Ice Frog against nerf. The nerf, you have a CM on your team, but...
Ice Frog nerf my mana, but I just need a CM on my team.
Yeah.
You're all good. And Fly loves CM. Or at least he's one of the few players that actually plays CM, even when CM was far, far away from any meta that there ever was.
Him and Ake.
Him and Ake.
And PPD.
And sometimes PPD, yes.
So what do you know? Two of the best captains and Ake.
They've got a good Iron Shell partner with the Earth Spirit, so you can dual lane down bottom. Earth Spirit can then even get an Iron Shell TP mid, TP top.
Yeah,
so.
And Darkseer is like a kind of run at you hero. That's really good against the Sniper. And it provides you more team fight compared to a Clockwork.
Well, they probably want like a fighting team oriented mid hero now, I guess, with that pick.
Maybe with someone that can use the Iron Shot.
Centaur doesn't really force supports to go up against him in the off lane, and Darkseer does, which is I think the biggest up that OG have right now.
You already have
melee supports.
You have Lone Druid, so you don't really need that much.
Exactly.
Like, Lone Druid can bully the.
So Earth Spirit and Crystal Maiden are going to be able to just do whatever and walk around and help out
really
the lanes.
That was a really good ban, though.
Yeah, I was thinking Alchemist too, actually.
That pick,
why is that?
It could make whole game so difficult for them because they have to deal with Alk and they have to deal with Lone Druid. And at the same time, the Darkseer plus Earth Spirit is going to be pressuring you so much. So
you have two melee supports against Darkseer. The lanes are already going to be tough for you. So.
That's not good if OG gets the Alchemy.
Okay, that makes sense. Great axe too.
They take out the Juggernaut. Pretty good carry for the lane against Darkseer because of the healing ward and the spin.
Just Anna left.
Yeah, I mean, there could be considerations with Lone Druid mid, but no, they go the Storm. So there's a hero that benefits from the CM Aura. Good gap closer against Sniper, and you see there's very there's somewhat limited lockdown for the Storm Spirit as well, with just, I mean, Centaur and Ogre's
Bounty Ogre's weakness. They don't have good lockdown.
Yep.
Yeah.
They have a lot of roam, a lot of moving potential, a lot of threat in the early game, like the first 10 minutes, but bypass that, you are going to have a Storm problem.
Yep.
Which they need to solve with the last pick.
We credited Team Secret onto having a good laning stage.
Oh, the Weaver!
With the last pick, Weaver, how do you feel like this?
We was really good against the Lone Druid, like we discussed before.
You're on Team Secret side?
Wait, oh yeah, yeah. Well, I agree with Winter. Weaver has been shown to be a very effective Lone Druid counter.
They're going to have a good laning phase, but they don't have good catch in the mid game for the Storm, so
who needs
they have to win the game in the early game with the Ogre and Bounty Hunter.
And the problem is, like, Sniper like doesn't push as fast as like a Lone Druid does. Yeah. So even if you win the early game, you're not looking like you're going to take towers at a very fast rate.
Yeah.
So.
Very tricky game for Secret.
Tricky game for Secret, but you're on Secret side. What do you got? What do you think?
I'm going to stick with OG on this one. I think Jerax's Earth Spirit with the Darkseer is just going to be a complete menace, so give OG a slight edge.
Yeah, same Winter? Thing. Tricky you said it was tricky for Secret, so yep. OG side.
What?
Let's
I'm gonna be on your side. I'm not a flip-flopper.
Oh, okay.
All right. Let's find out what our commentators think about this first game of the winner's bracket of Group A. It is OD and Fogged.
Thank you very much, Shiver and D then. Very exciting one of that as well. Secret versus OG. We've just seen the drafts, Fogged. What do you think about this? You know, Secret letting OG opening with that very, very strong Lone Druid and Earth Spirit. They themselves, the Ogre Sniper response. I mean, it's interesting stuff.
I really liked OG's draft overall. I think their opener was like super strong. They get two of their best heroes, and like the Lone Druid, obviously the best hero probably in this patch right now. And then the rest of their draft is just, I mean, amazing. They have incredible team fight. I think, like the panel mentioned though, their lanes may suffer a little bit just because of the Ogre and the Bounty Hunter. But at the same time, if their lanes, the thing that they can do to fix the lanes is with the Earth Spirit and Darkseer. They're going to be causing a lot of chaos. Jerax is going to be moving around with TPs, with the Ion Shell multiple times, so he'll be able to weather that storm. And mid-game, I just really, really like over everything about OG's lineup. Very little lockdown for the Storm Spirit, incredible high amount of team fight. Even if the game progresses to like later stages, they have two different very scaling cores. They have heroes that benefit from CM. They just have the whole kit and caboodle.
I mean, as well, the final pickup from Secret, you know, picking up that Weaver, it just seems like this is a game where OG can just absolutely splat the bug. You know, if they have the detection, just rolling in with the Earth Spirit, I mean, the silence, the root from the CM.
This is like the team fights. When I just look at OG's lineup, if they get like 15-minute mark, if it's fairly even, it's really hard. They can just siege towers with the Lone Druid. While Secret, they can siege towers decently because of the Sniper, but it's not the same. You don't kill buildings nearly as quickly, and then you have to worry about this massive amount of team threat from the Earth Spirit, Darkseer, Crystal Maiden.
Yeah, and this is a team, of course, as well, that OG, they've shown us before, you know, how well they can pull off this kind of vacuum into the Boulder Smash rolling Boulder combat. It's something that they've done time and time again. So I guess, you know, if you are Secret, it's all about just what kind of, as they've been mentioning, the kind of the early game laning control, the harassment, the pick-off potential. You know, if that bounty gets a good few levels, you're able to kind of set up in lane, allow the sniper to start peeping away from a mile off, picking up kills, and just trying to tackle OG when they're not at their five-man kind of full strength.
I think that's exactly why they picked the Weaver, so they can just leave him. Just let the Weaver do his own thing, leave him in maybe a 1v1 scenario, or in a 2v1 scenario where he can get levels, he can get like an okay farm, let the Ogre just run around, crush the Storm, Bounty Hunter sit for the Courier. If Storm doesn't get his Courier delivered and there's an Ogre in his face with the Sniper, he's going to be completely shut down. So that's the big thing that they can do to just like become really really big advantage for themselves in the laning phase.
Yeah, it's always interesting to see how that goes down in pro games, because you kind of look at drafts like this and you're like, as you mentioned, you know, that they cannot let that Courier go down. But we still see time and time again Bounty Hunters finding the opening to snipe the Courier.
Not just Bounty Hunters. Pylite Eye Bounty Hunters.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Pylite Eye Bounty Hunters. You've got to be very careful with that Courier. But surely that's something that OG will do. You imagine that they themselves, they're not going to let their Courier get sniped.
We'll probably see Fly walk with the bottle to the mid lane to deliver it to Ana, just to make sure of that. But also, listening to OG actually in the room earlier, in our like little talent room, whatever you want to call it thing, they were specifically talking about Crystal Maiden. They're like, so Fly, what hero can we make you shine on?
And you
when you're Warlock and stuff, you hit R, you know, good stuff. But Crystal Maiden, like, you can do some big stuff on this hero. So I thought it was pretty funny how they were just talking about it and they do grab it in this game.
And CM, it seems to be a hero as well that, I don't know if necessarily be the recent talents and such, but yeah. In pub games as well, this is a hero that it can do so much on its own if it gets a kind of an early few levels. You know, you're suddenly walking around the map, ganking, freezing people for ages, and the damage, you know, you get that talent, you're punching.
You know, we said it like five times too. It's a puppy bounty hunter. It's not Ty Lai Dai on the bounty.
The puppy bounty.
Because they want to make the ogre the five, and Pai usually plays the five, so they want puppy to be able to get that. So, okay, that's a different kind of approach, and they do.
Can he get that courier? I mean, he's already got his eyes around that lane, but indeed, Jarak sitting there.
Yeah, Jarak's gonna deliver it. Puppy also
on the guard.
I think he got a D ward, I believe, because he does have one CS. So, and I do see a sentry placed down while we were chatting.
Yeah, he must
so
have done that.
It looks like he
must
did get a D ward. He has a good amount, a good chunk of gold too.
Yeah. That's mid lane. Well, I die for the time being is going to be sitting around with mid once, doing his best to zone Anna back. And in return, we'll have Jarek's present to help him out here. I mean, of course, as we're seeing, it seems to kind of be less popular now, but it's having that ogre sitting mid in the earliest stages. Very, very strong at securing mid one, that early farm to open the game and making sure that Anna has a bit of a tough time getting a leg up at the start here.
Kind of what we expected for these lanes. Puppy actually blocks the hard camp with a ward, so he doesn't want Darkseer to be able to have a place to go back to after the laning phase just to accelerate his farm or anything.
And the other lanes are kind of up on top. Mikezu coming up forward at the moment, but no tail and fly. It's going to be. It feels kind of hard for this Centaur to get too close for anything. You know, these couple of heroes, that once they've got a level 2 or such,
yeah,
he can punch him back.
He's got his 2, and he might even just go to the jungle at this point with like his return. Just wait, because they're controlling the lane really well. Mid lane, Anna getting pressured heavily. 3 rotation.
They are going in, with Puppy behind him as well. Anna's very closed off to any sort of option of escape. He tries to bring that Pi with him, and he will do so. Not before the crew are able to secure themselves first blood as Puppy comes in with a final shift to the back.
If he had gotten that first blood, that would have been huge. That was very close.
And Secret realizing where the pressure needs to be applied early on and getting it done. I mean, did you kind of surprise you there's no reaction from the supports of OG there, or is there not a lot really kind of this CM and Earth Spirit can do in terms of turning around pressure like that being put on in the mid?
It was a bit surprising not seeing like either of them.
Because normally OG, they're the team that like bam, they react.
I think that they were focusing just so much on zoning out the Centaur. I think Fly even used his bite on a neutral to get his level 2, so he didn't have mana TP. He didn't have one either, so. It was just kind of, they just weren't ready for it at that moment in time. They were just prioritizing themselves rather than reacting.
Mid lane CS, 13 for 6 against the 9
bottom
for
lane,
2.
Bottom lane, MP, okay.
Yeah, he's
forces
just going
to
TP straight away.
TP out though, but that's big. He forces the Darkseer to TP the shrine. Okay, good play by S4 there. Go. So he can return nice and quickly.
And Jarek's back to hanging around a little bit closer to the mid lane. Anna is going to get gone on. Immediately plants the tree, Tango goes up, but as we can see, you know, Storm Spirit in the early stages of the game just absolutely melts to the pressure here. You know, Jarek Ignite and Shrapnel. Yeah, he's gonna roll himself out, but Puppy is there with the block, and Team Secret absolutely doing it here towards this kind of mid lane. This combination, Shrapnel and Ignite, you chase them down for miles.
We understood what they were going for, and they're executing it very well in this mid lane. Just the tri-lane mid, basically, to shut down Ana and force these 1v1 scenarios. And now they're forcing the rotations from the support, so now this is where Kezu gets back up toward that top lane, gets to get some more farming levels. Jarek actually was walking up to Ana there to try to boot him backwards, but I think he realized it was like too late at that point, and then he was just a little bit miscalculated.
The storm is just so squishy at this stage of the game.
Yeah.
And Ana will, of course, continue to return to that lane, but gets harder and harder. He's going to be fine for the time being. Puppy scan out what's going on towards the top. He'll look to take the bounty room for himself. Jarek's just like, it's already gone. And in fact, Jarek's had to be a little bit careful potentially if Kezu comes across, but it looks like they don't want to make a go onto the Earth Spirit.
Puppy's got like the dream bounty hunter start already. Orb of Venom and a raindrop, and he's scouting Ana.
Yeah, he's soaking up a lot of XP as well if he sticks around with the stack, and Ana is falling down low.
have a sentry, but it's not quite there. Puppy looking to make his go. He's level 3. He's got the shuriken.
Ooh,
he tanks a couple hits from the neutrals. He should be able to.
Oh, for sure. If Anna takes damage here.
The shrine's up, though. I think he might. Oh, no.
He's got south. He's got south.
Okay. That was scary, though.
And they're going to be very careful. Should have just spotted Puppy as he came into range.
S4, bottom lane. Highlight die in position. He's got slow on S4. Will he be able to get in range for the Fire Blast? They've got the Beatles on him. Will they continue to chase? He tries to TP out. Should be okay. And he gets
only GS Pi. Couldn't quite get in range there.
I think maybe if he bloodlusted himself instead of the Weaver, but you can see he wanted to bloodlust the Weaver to get closer. It was really nice TP out by S4. Fly, neutraling.
Yeah, he's been doing this pretty much the entirety of the game. So quick level.
Yeah, he's been doing a good job of like keeping vision of him too. He gets the ward down, walking around the jungle, so he keeps vision. He keeps like an idea of where the supports are.
I mean, this mid lane. Look at the farm the mid one's getting. It's not surprising, of course, down to the health that he's been getting from Pi.
Yeah.
But 34 for 15. He's not missing a creep, and obviously with the involvement on those kills as well. This sniper's going to be incredibly scary. He's getting to the point as well where, you know, if he gets a few early items, suddenly these heroes that are able to close the gap on him, they're not necessarily going to be able to kill him because of that advantage that Mib1's had in the laning stage.
And Puppy's being such a nuisance too already. Like, he's forcing the reaction from the supports, but not only the reactions, he's forcing them to spend their money on sentries. So Fly has already bought 3 sentries to try to or 4 sentries to defend his Storm Spirit, and he hasn't netted a kill on Puppy yet. Anna, still getting scouted out this entire time by Puppy.
Mid one going across with a very aggressive movement here into the jungle. It will be spotted out by an OG ward. So they know what's going on. No Tail as well knows that he's in potential trouble, but again, just this warding that they have down. Keeping them very safe. In fact, he'll just turn towards Puppy, who's still in range of the sentry ward, and
almost gets him.
Just gets out of range.
Very close. Now this is where, you know, they're gonna play to their strength for OG. They're gonna go to the Darkseer lane, but Ana now gonna get punished again. About it, level 6, and he gets brought down.
I mean, this mid lane, mid 1 and Pi, they've executed it absolutely perfectly.
Alright, let's see. They're trying to defend this bottom tower. Fly and Jarex already in position. They have the sentry in the tree line too. Ready to go for aggression on the Weaver.
See if they can do anything about this here. OG, they need to try and find an aggressive play themselves. Looking towards MP, they will find the setup there. And MP, they'll be able to get his way out of that one. Quick and easy kill for OG, and certainly a kill that they needed.
Very, very needed kill. Very big one. They get the Darkseer Arcane Boots now too, so he restores his supports manas, and they're able to continue their aggression with the Ion Shell.
Well, they could certainly try for something else here. Only Puppy and Pi in the neighborhood at the moment. But with the sentry down, but they themselves have the sentry out here. Puppy tries to get across so he can take the sentry down first, and he will make it. So he will be able to maintain control of that area of the map just by that tier 1 bottom. Again, though, I know because of the pressure being put on down on the bottom lane, Ana.
Nice.
That's a nice little dodge.
Yeah, I think that's what you want. You click yourself and you just do the little one, but mid lane, it's where Jarex going. He's Ion Shell too.
They could get Ana this kill onto mid one. Absolutely brilliant there for OG.
Completely reverses everything that happened in the laning.
But this is the lane where this Storm Spirit was getting dominated because of the pressure that Secret were putting on with their numbers. And just like that, you know, Jarex, he has the levels. He can now turn up and he can now abuse the fact this sniper has been left alone.
We might see a courier snipe here. Oh, nope. Fly spotted him with the sentry ward.
I mean, these sentry placements from OG have been perfect. They're everywhere.
They're pinging
all
it.
In the favorable kind of positions the Puppy wants to be in.
Yeah, they know he's there.
They know he's there.
Yeah.
They've got his number.
So, 4-3. Bit of a slow one, but the great rotations coming up from both teams, but it's already going almost 1,000 gold into favor of OG just because of the free farming lone druid.
If they can get mid one again, I mean, look at this. Jarex looking for the setup. Doesn't hit the immediate bowl rolling body, but does get the bowl to smash. The roof's there from the CM. They'll take down one, but the turnaround's now coming through from Secret. Jarex to fall. Ana and S4 both incredibly low here. They've lost 2 OG. They're almost certainly going to lose 3 as S4 tries to duke it out. He's going to be hitting the floor for 25 seconds. As that was not worth it there for the side of OG. They get the sniper, but losing 3 heroes for it in the mid lane.
Yeah, not able to get the boulder on him initially before he gets shrapnel off, so they're all just caught under shrapnel under the tower. Good rotations coming out from Secret, picking themselves up. Three kills, but no-tail right away. This is typical no-tail lately, especially like for the past maybe 5 months, 6 months, he's been doing this a lot. When he sees the opportunity, he leaves his safe lane and just goes and takes the enemy safe lane tower. That was a very good rotation by him during that chaos.
Top of the CS and top of the net worth at the moment, no-tail. That lone druid, and we've seen it already today. How scary it can get if it's given the space, and so far it is getting it.
The big thing that I'm really liking for Secret is that Kezu is halfway to a blink dagger. So he's been left pretty much alone up here now for quite a while, and that's going to be a really big pickup to close the gap onto the lone druid, and even onto the to have the setup for the storm spirit, because they don't have that much lockdown for him, but they do have the center, which is the big one, and they have a lot of burst damage.
Actually, smoke up here from Secret. They are going to look for a bit of a movement here into the jungle of OG. We'll see if they can try and catch up one of the big cores. Anna at the moment in the safe lane is going to be the target, almost certainly. Pi and mid one.
OG, no, OG looks like they know what's up right now, actually, though. They're making their own rotation.
It looks like they're a little too far away, though. I mean, Anna is going to be able to sip himself back. They are going to dive initially. They'll just put a bit of harassment down on Tenna, but okay, with the wraparound for Puppy, they've got him. Secret take the kill.
OG yeah, wants to go in.
They do. They don't have this storm, so they will be fighting without one of their cores. If no-tail can get a good route onto someone, maybe with the bear, they could go for it. Kezu tries for the TP out, but there we have it. The stun's there in time, and Kezu will be left behind here by the rest of his team. So OG do find something in return.
Doesn't want to lose gold, so he actually picks up the majority of his hood instead of going for that straight blink rush.
I mean, I guess both would be fine. I mean, Hood's going to be absolutely massive this game with the amount of magical damage that OG's going to be looking to do in these team fights.
Yeah, his job is, of course, you could want a blink dagger to get the initiations, but his job in this game is just to protect his sniper.
For sure, yeah.
You definitely want him to get, like, that pipe, assuming that comes to guard this game eventually, just to be able to get that, but I think the Aghanim's is probably just a blink Aghanim's after the Hood, or the pipe is definitely the ideal.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if we see in some of these fights just, you know, Kezu can't, if the, as you said, the sniper mid one's in danger, Kezu just stamping straight into the middle of OG, who's stomping and staying alive long enough for sniper to be able to walk his way out of there.
Yeah.
If things start to go to pot for Secret. In the moment, 8 for 5.
Super back to
12 minutes in. It's certainly seeming to be the close match that you'd hope between these two sides.
Yeah, Secret did, like, we said it like multiple times on the panel and everything, they all said it too. It's just, they needed to be very aggressive in this laning phase, and their draft enabled them to be able to with this, the Weaver just being able to be left on his own.
This will come in handy. Yeah, big warning from both sides around this area. They've both got their vision up. So OG know will Secret if we head over. Secret keeping themselves to their own half of the map at the moment.
So No-tail's carrying his own dust on his own, on his bear. So he's going to be looking for like opportunities to use that for his teammates as well. What a team. Like, this is just typical No-tail. I call him Bro-tail in Boston, but he really is just one of the biggest team players. Always getting involved in like majority of the kills. Buys dust and sentries for his team. Look, he has bear sentries on his backpack of his bear, too.
Like, but would he have bought the sentries?
I don't think he bought the sentries. Nah, I think he bought the dust, though. Yeah.
You think about, okay.
No. It doesn't say like owned, like bought by blah, blah, blah or anything, but pretty sure he bought it himself. Either way, having it on him is very good for...
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the bear's kind of... Yeah, you're always going to have a chance to get that out. No problems at all in the fight. Before you go down, if you do so, bottom left... Oh, hang on! He picked it back up, didn't he? I was going to say, that was looked a little close there. I think Anna dropped what the point booster before he saw ring as MP came across.
Gets pressured very hard. Tower trades coming out, mid tower drops, top tower drops. See if in the retreat, OG's able to find anything. They know that Puppy's walking over, but yeah, they don't want to fight. They know the Weaver's rotating over.
And it's going to certainly get a little harder for OG as well in terms of coordinating movements around the map with this track online from Puppy. You know, keeping that kind of vision of, you know, these heroes that as we talked about in the draft, are going to be looking to pull off these combos is going to be absolutely massive for Secret and their ability to avoid being caught out by a massive kind of vacuum wall into boulder smash combos.
Yeah, they have no-tail free farming and they have that wombo combo like you're saying and everything, and this is the time where it's the strongest. But Ana actually is having like a really hard time finding anywhere to get his farm on. Every time he's been going to a lane, they just start pressuring him with spells and he's forced to zip out or just go back to base and completely. And Stampede going out, trying to go for a kill onto No Tail in the bottom lane, but he is very aware of what's going on. Maelstrom now finished up on the bear.
Oh, hey, 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 Puppy! Lai knows he's there. That sentry placement, he was ready for that. Fly with the great kind of game sense there. I think it looks like, I guess, well, they had the sentry further at the river, so I guess he must have seen him coming across.
Yeah.
And he was prepared for that flight. There's always a sentry ready on the side of OG this game. Always got the detection.
Yeah, OG's so ready to fight. They have mech online now.
I mean, No Tail.
Very far in.
He's trying to go in. I mean, he said he's a bit of a team player, but well, where's the team? They are turning up. Do they want to try and fight this, though, with No Tail already going down? That's the question. Already S4 looking to surge his way out of this. OG looks like this may not be the fight. They do hit a beautiful combo. Is it enough, though? The Magnetize comes out, but the damage, it's not quite there for OG. They've lost three. They're going to be losing four. And Secret, they should all survive. The Shrine's up and ready. Secret will live. Four down on OG. I mean, it all looks a little bit questionable after No Tail went down so quickly. I mean, it looked like they were obviously looking to set up some sort of a bait with the Lone Druid,
yeah,
but maybe just went down a bit quicker than they expected.
Something that actually Fly says a lot is patience is key. So there, No Tail, I think, being a little bit too impatient, goes for this very aggressive play onto the sniper and ends up really costing his whole team with it. They all end up trying to go for this Wombo combo with the vacuum and the Darkseer mech.
And they did hit it.
And they get it perfectly.
The damage is...
Yeah. They didn't have either of their big cores. They didn't have the Storm Spirit there. The Lone Druid was already dead. Does give Ana a little bit of space to push out the top lane, almost get himself the top tower, and getting closer to the Bloodstone. But yeah, definitely not really wanting to pick a fight in the enemy jungle right in between the Shrine and the Tier 2.
Let's see if OG... I mean, do OG need to attempt to go for those sort of plays? At the moment, they have banned around by the Roshan pit, so there's a freebie here as they roll in and take down Puppy.
I think this is just where they're at their strongest. You know, they have the mech darks here, they have the level 6s on the heroes that need it. So I think they just want to pick fights. They want to make space for Ana as much as possible with the Lone Druid, since he's so powerful right now with the rest of their team fight.
Yeah, and there's certainly some scary item timings that they're up against. You know, if MP is able to get his Desolator in good time, it is going to be very, very scary in terms of just being able to maneuver himself to the back lines and really bring down those kind of supports like Jarrax after he's committed the spells already into the fight. It's all about the positioning and all about the vision control this game. Again, you know, Fly consistently having two sentries to roll. They need to make sure that they have just fantastic vision around wherever they want to fight this matchup, because they've always got to worry about Puppy and MP just sneaking around at the back lines and getting themselves into positions that OG won't expect them to be.
That's why I really like the way Puppy or Pi have been warding. Mostly Puppy in this game is very defensive wards in his own jungle. Pi, you know, he's doing his split push thing, but
yeah,
he's going to pay with his life this time. But yeah, Puppy's been really like understanding the way that the game is going to be. He's like, OG's going to go aggressive on us here, so I'm going to ward defensively. I'm going to watch their movements with my own body instead of that. So definitely being able to net themselves a couple things. But yeah, losing Pi there, it doesn't really mean much. He was pressuring the lane. He's getting good levels. That's like a typical Pi thing, typical Pi place to die.
Oh yeah, just shoving out the lane as a support.
Yeah.
And hoping for the best, but not being surprised when the worst comes through. Mid lane, MP, see who will pick off this tower here. Jarrax, who's going to try for the die, isn't going to get it, because Kezu meeting him with a blink. They will vacuum and drop the wall here. OG trying to turn this one around. Jarrax falling low, and in fact, he's out. The silence catches out MP, though. No chance for a time lapse. They'll lose the Weaver, they'll lose the Centaur. And at the end of the day, it's a little bit messy there from the side of Secret. You know, they go and they do get the tower, but losing two cores, I don't really want to say that's worth it, Pop.
Ana had just picked up his Bloodstone too, so he picked up two charges from that.
Definitely not.
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely not.
He gets the.
Not happy with that one.
I think he got the killing. Oh no, Jarrax actually got the dominating kill streak from MP. So Jarrax, I think Jarrax actually could have lived. He had 11 stick charges and he wasn't stunned, so he was like, he just was unable to get it. Just a little bit of a small misplay by him, but he got the silence off and he netted his Storm Spirit. Two kills on his Bloodstone timing, so
huge.
Ana is completely caught up on his way toward his Orchid, even has a regen in his bottle for the next fight.
Oh, well, as we see, you know, OG making a mistake early on that bottom lane, Secret in turn, and making the best of moves there towards the mid.
Puppy during that the debacle in the mid lane. Gets the two very aggressive wards up, so he's able to read the movements coming out from OG out of the base. He gets one in their jungle near the high ground, and then one in the bottom lane near the tier 2 tower. So just gonna be able to read them, see the movements much clearer.
Spoke up for the secret. No wards there from OG, so they do have the element of surprise here, secret.
They do know the blink was on. The blink is on Kezu now because of the reveal from the mid lane. So,
OG may.
They look like they know something's up right now.
Can they get the jump in? Jarek's at the moment towards the bottom, but he's keeping himself the safe side of the tower. Rest of OG, they are back up. I mean, they realize there's so many heroes off the map. Fly is going to be the one to get caught though. Immediately jump taken down by Kezu.
Track money.
And Secret can put on a fair bit of pressure now. MP does have that Deso complete. It's going to be picking up the BKB next. Absolutely needed against this Earth Spirit, Silence and Control.
Yeah, that's actually a really good point too. Mid one is very close to it. That really messes up OG's team fight.
Yeah, BKB is a huge scam for Secret. And Anna, top lane. Again, just juking out the Assassinate. In fact, his turns, and he picks up a free kill on Puppy. Anna, styling him.
Oh, Kezu grabs him. Oh, he's gonna have to suicide.
He certainly is gonna have to kill himself, and he did.
Nice. We'll
get the deny
Kezu
off. Kezu. Some very nice Blinku stomps.
On his back. Quick respawn from that 16 Bloodstone charges that he had.
Yeah, fortunately, he did have those extra charges, so only a couple behind the original now. Oh, certainly has to be careful about the way that he goes around pushing out those side lanes next time. Kezu will consistently looking to get that jump.
What do we got No-Till going for here? Okay, No-Till's just rushing a Scotty. Not going for like the Dragon Lance or anything. Just getting very tanky. Pi.
Maybe about to build back up one of his Bloodstone charges, and indeed will do so as Pi's caught out. Jarek's looking to chase. Just picked up the Blink Dagger as well on this Earth Spirit. So OG themselves, that extra bit of catch potential. Mid one. Go for the TP out from the side chop here. They don't manage to get themselves close enough in time, OG. They are going to go for a smoke, though.
At the shrine, they look like they want a battle. They saw them both resetting. They see Kezu. They don't see MP just yet. MP does spot them.
Oh, they'll go for the Centaur, immediately jumping in. Now he's got that hood out. It's buying him some time. He's fairly tanky. Gets the Hoostomp and the double edge out on the way down, but he does fall. Can Secret do anything in return here? Puppy's heading forward. And it goes for the TP away.
The freezing field with the vacuum.
Yeah. Fly CM. He knows what he's doing. He knows he's safe to go for big ults like that with the lockdown effectively off the map from Secret in that situation where they're already dead.
Hey, they wanted to make Fly look flashy, you know? He clicked R and he got a bunch of kills and stuff, but no. That was very good teamwork by them. Ana ends up surviving too. So just 4 kills going the way of OG, and they get to get some more pressure going on and more aggressive wards. So clearing up the tier 2 and getting a lot more map control. This is, that's a big swing of momentum for sure.
Absolutely, OG. This is a solid play. They will lose the bear here. As a 300 will be pocketed into the bank of the sniper. But yeah, as you mentioned, very interested to see No-Till go for these builds. He always seems to like change what he does on this lone druid. It's very situational. I mean, I guess that's the great thing with this hero as a core. There's a lot of different ways you can build him as this range guy, isn't there? You can go for the damage, you can get the early desolate, as we saw him do. He didn't end up doing, but we have seen previous lone druid builds go for something like that. And as you said this time around, the maelstrom into the Scardy, it's going to be very hard to take down.
Yeah, he really, I think those functors, I'm already going to get gap closed. They have a Stampeding Centaur, they have a Weaver, they have a Bounty Nuke and run on me with the Stampede and everything. So I just need to bulk up.
Yeah.
So might as well just go for that. I'm still curious about not having the Dragon Lance though. I mean, it's gotten nerfed a bit.
I guess it's kind of like Ben was saying when we were casting the other game where we played Madrid, where he kind of just, he obviously skipped the Dragon Lance early on because Ben felt it kind of slows you down. Anna tried for an Aegis still there, doesn't make it. Vacuum will be dropped by OG, but it looks like they're just going to disengage. They don't want to try and fight the Aegis as of yet, with some of their ults already committed there in that fight with the wall drop as they'll back away. But yeah, as Ben was saying, getting the Dragon Lance, it's like, well, you're kind of getting a halfway item when if you're in a good position and you've got the farm, you can get something big done, like a Scardy or
absolutely.
As we saw last game by the Mouth, very early on.
And, you mean, especially versus that lineup, too. Like, Dragonlance makes you stay away when yeah. they're going to really close the gap on you anyway, so.
For sure, yeah.
Definitely understandable. I'd go for that.
Mid one, of course, with that BKB, and now looking to complete that Maelstrom into the Mjolnir. Fly is starting to rack up the... What's the item for Fly this game? Are we going to see the Glimmer Cape come through? Is that necessary for the team? Is there anything else that he can get to help out?
Bottom lane. Nice little pickup from Derek with that Blink Dagger that you mentioned before.
That's a spirit play.
Ana should be close to his Orchid very soon with another regen in his bottle, but I think Fly might... I don't know, maybe he'll just save for like Blink, because they already have track for the Glimmer. They already have a bunch of like... They already have like a lot of different reveal and everything too, so...
Oh, Fly, he found CM, but Kezu, he's found Fly. Jumps in immediately with the burst, but Fly, oh, finally goes down there. The assassinate flies through. But OG, they're the ones to clean up three here in this situation, mid one. Immediately TPing out.
OG responds so quickly in the mid game when they have aggression. I mean, sure, in this position, it's very deep into their jungle, but five heroes instantly arrive as soon as Fly's in trouble. But yeah, I'm not too sure. Fly's just saving gold. Maybe he's still deciding to. He doesn't. I think the Blink Dagger might be pretty decent just to get the catch,
yeah.
get into the backline on top of the sniper, because they both have like that kind of thing where they're both trying to get through the tanky frontliners onto those squishy backliners.
Mid one has got complete Mjolnir. I mean, mid one's farm this game has been absolutely
ridiculous.
Fantastic. Yeah, keeping himself ahead of a Lone Druid. You know, Lone Druid then had a very good timing on that Maelstrom. A very fast farmer himself. It's sniper versus the new sniper. You know, fogged whether you like old or new. Lone Druid versus sniper himself. And we'll see who prevails this game. At the moment, 26 minutes in now, 15-18. I mean, who would you say has the edge? I mean, how close is this game in your eyes at the moment?
I'm not even too sure, to be honest. I think it's just very even, just because of the BKB from mid one, the Roche that they picked up from Secret. It's really hard to say. I would say maybe OG with a slight edge once the Aegis goes down. They just want to wait, don't really pick a fight into it, just because they don't have a crazy amount of lockdown for the Storm, so the Storm can excel. And there's a lot of like chaos happening in the fight with the Earth Spirit and the Darkseer already. And I mean, Lone Druid is just a ridiculous hero, to be honest. It's still one thing that I have to always go back on. Minus 40 second respawn, he hits his level 20 now.
There we go, Smoker from Secret. What can they find here? OG again already backing off. I mean, you know, when you have these five-man smokes, OG seeing that the map is empty at this moment in time, they are going to play it safe and holding on to themselves on that high ground. They're not going to let themselves get caught out by this movement from Secret.
Great awareness.
Just taking the time to read the situation and make sure the Secret don't get a leg up on them. And now with MP and Sniper revealing themselves back down bottom, OG will realize that they're now safe to come back out onto the map. And in fact, a TP across to that shrine down bottom. Fly looks like he's just looking to get some war control back on this area.
Right now is where I feel like MP is very vulnerable, because he doesn't have his Lincolns, he doesn't have his BKB or anything, and Ana has his Orchid. So he has to watch his positioning in these fights, and they have to make sure that they use Kezu and his pipe very effectively. Not to overcommit in any way, because they can just get jumped in the back lines very easily from this farm Storm Spirit now.
Nice little play there from Puppy, though. As soon as Fly, you know, wards up that area, he immediately comes in with the D ward. They'll take themselves the tier 2 down bottom. Mid lane, no tail starting to put on pressure. Jarek's in the neighborhood. But the TP's coming back from Secret. It's going to be very hard for OG to make any sort of play here. Just these two of them that they have at the moment. TP's coming in towards the shrine. Ana already zipping himself out.
Cute play there by No Tail. Ana's pushing the tower. And oh, speaking of that, goes for a solo kill on Defy. And he gets it for himself with that DD and Orchid.
16 Bloodstone charges. He's back up to Ana.
But yeah, Ana's split pushing the tier 2, and the bear is standing on top of the shrine to scout for him and fear anyone who does TP in to try to go for that play onto him. So, nice little teamwork there coming out from OG.
S4, Pipe and Greaves done. Blink queued up as his next item. His point of call, Jarex. Keeping his eyes on that top lane. And this time it's Secret themselves actually backing up to their own high ground. OG will smoke up. We'll see how safe Secret do play it. They are coming out themselves. No wards at the moment from OG on this kind of area of the map down in Secret's jungle. So half of themselves to make a move. Maybe looking to try and bait it out with No Tail in the mid lane. They only have him revealing at the moment in time. Secret just keeping to the high ground in their own jungle in case OG come round. And indeed they are. Jarek's leading the way. Can he find the lockdown?
No Aegis right now, so they have a big window right now to just be on the aggression with that Orchid pickup. They're just a little bit ahead right now since the Darkseer as well. S4 has a good chunk of money over Kezu, who's very far from that Aghanim Scepter, which he definitely needs this game. S4 is able to just farm without like, showing on the map, obviously, with the Ion Shells forcing lanes in.
Yeah, both teams just doing a good job of avoiding each other at this moment. Secret go for a smoke. OG, they're well out of the way. OG go for a smoke. Secret, they're reading them.
Good Dota.
It really, really is. I mean, they kind of joked about it on the panel, how well these teams were going to know each other. In terms of play style and what they like to do at certain times of the game, and yeah, it certainly seems apparent in the way that they're reacting to each other so far.
Kind of mirroring in a way. It's definitely nice to watch.
So who's going to make the first slip up? That's the question.
MP has his BKB now, so his vulnerability stage has gone down, but he still can get caught by the Wombo combo when Starkseer has Blink Dagger, since they do have Jarex with it. Whoa, they do need to still watch the way that they stand together. That's the big thing that Secret has to still be careful for in these fights, how they clump, because there still is that massive Wombo combo on the side of OG.
Bottom lane, OG ready to put the pressure on. See if Kezu, of course, he's pretty much the main initiator. It's about him getting in with a good hoof stomp, allowing Secret to lay down the damage behind him. Both teams, this could be a bit of a big old clash down here. They're both prepping for fight.
This could be a really big point in the game.
Who's going to get the jump on who? That's the question. Jarek's starting to close in on the tree line on the bottom. He'll look for the big blink combo.
Here we go, Kezu going in.
Yeah, looks to immediately jump in onto Notel. Will back up, but stole the combo there. The Vaccine Wall to three. It is beautiful, but it's not going to go out of the gears to start off with. BKB comes out. They'll lose one. That's going to be Kezu out on the silence for 50 seconds. He got the Stampede off in time, though. So Puppy's able to get himself back to safety. So at the end of the day, it's just one going down. But this is a nice 40-second window that OG can see if they can get anything more done with. Notel fairly low. Has to back himself out and away. Mid one didn't actually have to use the BKB in that fight. He's still got his charge available. OG still want to fight though. Anna comes across, immediately zipping in and taking down that sniper mage. So there's no chance for the BKB usage. They'll get themselves, and that was exactly what OG wanted. One kill, it's nice, it's not good enough. Three kills, absolutely perfect there for the side of OG. They'll take the tier two down bottom. They could even be in a position to pressure the high ground. You know, this. Yep. Is a sniper down for 50 seconds and immediately buys back. OG now forcing out that buyback as well. That's the momentum that they were looking for.
That was huge. The wards that fight were really important for OG. They do this little fake backup and they just see everybody, the sniper on the shrine, gets the pull before he's able to get the BKB off. And that's the worry of playing with sniper versus these gap closers. Even though he does have the BKB, just gets bursted.
Because of that chain lockdown as well. You know, even if they hadn't killed him during that, there's always going to be that follow-up lock to take him out from Jarek's coming in with a good boulder smash.
Yeah, and the Wombo combo there again. Like, even though the BKBs are there, it wasn't like, you know, five heroes died, only one hero died, but the way that they land the combo is just so perfect.
I mean, they're hitting three heroes there, and it's in a situation as well. You know, Secret knew that OG were there. They were preparing for it the best that they can. It didn't look like they were clumped up at all, but yeah, just S4 finding perfect positions to grab them from the tips of the edge of that vacuum.
Yeah, honestly, this is a big next pickup. 19 Bloodstone charges, he's got the Orchid and then the Shiva. So he's got the physical resistances now from that, and he's able to scout out easier with the Shiva's guard and isolate people and just slow them down.
I mean, it really does start to feel like, you know, this is kind of the classic Anna we're getting used to. You know, this is a player that a lot of people target in that mid lane. They know that they can abuse that, get those early kills onto him, but he's very good at bringing himself back into this game. Third highest on the net worth, as you said, absolutely has the tools that he needs to get the job done at this stage of the game. And as we saw in that last fight, just immediately getting the perfect initiation onto the right heroes, disabling that sniper, making sure the mid one gets no chance to play his way out of it. Oh. It's very, very scary.
They just got a crit for them. And he has dust on the bear still.
Dust, he's dead. Well, guess who's there? Anna immediately in, picks up another Bloodstone charge.
The dust on the bear, man. This is so legit. They do have a jam on Jerax, but Jerax wasn't in position for that one there.
Man with flies, and again, Anna comes across. There'll be a buyback from Puppy here as he realizes his team is starting to fall apart a little bit. Anna, it will follow through, looking for the kill, gets it. Boost on from Kezu onto Jerax, but he doesn't have the damage to finish him off. Anna, a little low on the tank on mana, but he still wants to fight. Goes across, looks towards Puppy. Puppy, have enough regen to keep himself alive, but with the Orchid and the damage, Anna will take it. And a triple kill for this Storm Spirit. I mean, this time, many times I've talked up a player and then they've done something awful. As I said, Anna was doing great, and we just saw there, picking up a triple kill, up to 22 Bloodstone charges.
58 mana per second, not a whole lot of disable on the side of Secret for the Storm Spirit either, so he's just...
He is terrifying at this stage in the end.
Yeah.
Very, very impressive indeed, and OG now into the pit. A quick Rosh. I'm imagining Anna's got a slot. He's just on the Storm as well. Yeah. He's got a space for that in his pockets.
The power of these, you know, teamfight heroes, where Secret doesn't really have any teamfight on their team at all. It's like the Centaur, sure, Shrapnel, and like Bloodlust. These aren't really like teamfight abilities. While OG has a very teamfight-centric lineup, as we mentioned multiple times. Fly did pick up that Blink Dagger we did see a bit ago, and then that gem as well for Jerax. So the map control dwindles heavily for Secret, and it's just OG on the clear aggression.
Straight on this tower. We'll see what Secret can do to hold. They're still without the sniper for 20 seconds. Caught out by the Hoostom. Moving down low. Kills the zip out before the double edge comes through. Silence to Kezu as well.
They don't want to lose the edges here.
Keep it safe. There's no need to panic on the side of OG.
I mean, they can just reset right now. They can go back, push the two side lanes out a bit, and then just come back with Ana and go for that again. Because they have Voltis, they have teamfight ultimates, but theirs aren't really that massive cooldown dependency, or they don't really need to expend that many to get a lot of these kills just because of how massive Ana is. He can do a lot of this on his own. Puppy gets spotted out by Jerax.
Oh, and he's dusted as well. That'll be another Bloodstone charge in the pocket. I mean, it really feels, at this point, you kind of mentioned it earlier, the item that I feel the Secret are missing, it is the Axe on the Centaur.
Yeah.
If they have that, they can stop OG from getting these quick kickoffs to kick off these fights and, you know, allow OG to just look to chase down for more. You know, hold one back with the Yule Scepter, but again, the vacuum onto two. There we have him bringing in the Weaver. MP does get the chance to time that. This could be the turnaround that Secret needs. Gotell falling incredibly low here. Anna as well, very low on the mana. Assassinate comes through from the mid one. He'll take down Gotell. He's grinding himself a second, and he's not done yet. This is what Secret needed. They'll chase down Jerax. S4 on the retreat as well. Jerax turns around, kicks Kezu back. And MP, he's got the vision thanks to the Assassinate there. Anna comes back in. Will actually clean up the Weaver kill. And Anna, he's not done. He's got no mana, but he doesn't need it. He takes down a second.
The neutral creep, the Mud Golem gets the last hit on this.
All right, that's tilt worthy, yeah.
But they do recover their gem. They lose a couple heroes on the retreat. Mid one, able to just sit in the back lines there and get just straight up DPS the whole time. Did not stop attacking during the entire time just because of where the fight was taken. But Ana did not die. Does,
I mean, that's the big
keep the Aegis again.
And those 26 Bloodstone charges.
Yeah. 26 Bloodstone charges, Aegis, and he's on his way toward it. Actually, he has his.
Very close to the 20. Can we check out the 25 talents again?
You take the spell.
Yeah.
Like 0.75 Vortex.
Dude,
is way too little.
I guess it is. If it was maybe, double that, then you could totally see it being useful for disabling the sniper before he gets a chance to BKB. But,
yeah. The one nice thing is that the spell lamp affects your Orchid and your Shivas. Yeah. 0.75, right? So little.
0.75. That's not good.
Yeah, it just amplifies your Orchid damage, amplifies your shield. It amplifies everything. So you'd want to get the magic complication. Even though 10 on a storm at 20 bucks, it seems pretty underwhelming, but.
Well, that's a shrine in the pocket for them as well. 29 to 18. I mean, this was a game that was. It was very close, but OG just starting to sail away. You can see it over on the team net worth graph. It's a 20k lead now for OG. Has kind of just come across it in pretty much the last 10 minutes has been the really painful moments for the side of Secret. And Kezu's caught out in the mid lane. Bam! He's out and down. 70 seconds on the sidelines.
No buyback.
Does not have the money. Doesn't. Probably has the money actually. Probably the time. No, he doesn't have the money. Don't mind about it. He does not have the money. He's poor as a poor person.
Yeah, he tried to go for that Axe. He's still trying to build up to it, but just not able to find the farm. But, I mean, like you said, if they're losing every fight in the past 12 minutes just because OG is just getting the jumps on them every time, that's what's going to happen. You're not winning fights as Centaur. That hero doesn't farm. That hero fights. You got to get money through kills for the most part.
But OG now coming towards the mid lane. They are ready to try and go for a high ground siege. See what they can get done here. We'll get the D ward on an outside observer ward that was just outside of the base there of Secret, trying to give them that vision that they need, anything that they can to help them just hold against this siege. But immediately just in with the Mantis Star, Lone Druid Illusions, mid one forced to put the BKB as Ana zips past the Rax, but the melee Rax are already down. OG got what they came for. Bottom lane MP was putting pressure onto the tier 3, does manage to take it in a bit of a split push attempt. OG are already back. And make sure that MP doesn't get anything more than the tier 3 bottom. So tier 3 bottom taken by Secret, but it's OG with that big, big takedown of the melee racks in the mid lane as both teams look to back up.
It's so fearful that Ana can actually just do that. Just zip onto the sniper and force him to BKB, because now he has Lincolns, he has the Aegis. 78 mana per second on the Storm Spirit with his 27 Bloodstone charges. And yeah, he's just an absolute monster now at this point. And Noto actually went back to the dragon.
He went back.
He did go back. After his Mjolnir, Manta, and his Ice Scotty, he went for it for the siege.
It's one of the... Yeah, absolutely, for the siege, yeah. It's certainly worth picking up at that stage.
Yep, he's got his level 25 too, so he's got that very short cooldown on Savage Roar, only 10 seconds on that. Which other ones do we have? Who else is close to something big? We're gonna have S4 almost level 20, so he gets the cooldown reduction or the larger vacuum AoE. Either one could work in this game.
How much is the cooldown reduction?
It's 10%, so it's kind of low. The vacuum's only 75 as well, but he's been landing like 3-man vacuums. We'll see. I think that one's
I guess close. You take the 10%, don't you?
Yeah.
I mean, it's cooldown reductions.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. Even when it seems smooth.
Yeah. But yeah, Secret completely just...
Yeah, staying in the high ground at the moment.
Yeah. Trapped in their base. They do have a gem out on Puppy, but he can't really walk out to... get rid of any wards just because of how, yeah, like we mentioned, the Storm Spirit, 80 mana per second. He can jump across the map already very easily.
OG coming together at the bottom half of the map now. We'll see if they are ready to be in a position to try and go for a second set of melee racks.
Oh, maybe. We've got Jerax with Blink Aghanim.
People gonna get stunned.
We're gonna see some fun stuff. We're gonna see some people getting kicked out of the base, probably.
Let's see what they can find here. Obviously, it's very hard to find any members of Secret at the moment, as they are waiting for that high ground siege from OG. They do not want to take a fight outside of their base.
Yeah, safest play for OG is just keep lanes pushed in, wait for Roche. They have been playing very disciplined. Even in their games versus TNC, when they were very far in advantage, they played very, very cool and collected. They just waited to take towers. They just waited for the rush. We'll probably see them do that again. It's just typical OG that they play very methodically.
Hurricane Pike complete for Noto now. We'll have that out and on the ready for the next push. But again, as you said, yeah, OG... absolutely no reason to not play as safe as they are.
Yep. They're farming the like everywhere on the map. Like Fly's taking their jungle, the Lone Druid and Ana are taking their jungle. Derek is just running around. Darkness here is just Ion Shelling Waves and pushing it out. Let's see what he went for. He went for the cooldown reduction. I kind of expected. He did wait a second though, so he was deciding his thoughts in this game.
On mid lane, here we have a bit of a kickoff. Yeah, they're trying to initiate Ana. Looking towards Pi and MP. MP time lapses. Shikushi's himself back up to the high ground, and OG won't be able to find the kill. But at the least, just kind of showing the dominance there, the control they have on the map, and just threatening Secret any time that Secret start to kind of, you know, dribble out of the base.
Yeah, trying to force BKBs as well is pretty important. They have the liberty and the freedom to be able to do that. They can just have that happen. They didn't make him force the BKB, but yeah, they can do it pretty easily. Here we go. Secret smoked up.
Going for the big place. I mean, this is at the point as well where what Roshan could be respawning. So
yeah, and the Aghanim's on the Centaur was finally picked up, so they do have that damage reduction. And mid one has mid one actually does a ton of damage.
I like the Daedalus pickup.
Yeah.
That is an item that people don't build anymore. I mean, people go for Bloodthorn and stuff. Well, he's found Notel, and indeed, Pi and Puppy look to slow him down. He's got the Manta style.
He's pretty tanky, but they should be able to bring him down.
Ooh,
oh,
and
he's got the hurricane fight. He's getting.
Nah, he's too slippery. No tail looks to be A-OK for the time being. Secret. You know, they're worried. You know, if you're not killing No Tail immediately, you know that there's going to be a reaction.
Uh-oh. Here comes the whole unit.
Oh, Kezdo, though, again with
No-Tail
a fantastic boost stomp. No Tail could have pushed one off Anna. Sends it onto the Weaver. Follow up Vacuum, but MP immediately costs the BKB. They'll look towards the Storm, but Anna just zipping out. He's got a huge amount of mana to play with. MP trying to continue to chase down No Tail. Hasn't quite got the damage to bring down the Lone Druid. As OG just back up, back away, neither the team finding the kill. Middle lane though, Secret may just lose three tracks for free here, and indeed they do. The Dire creeps end up finishing off that middle lane, range wrecked.
Yeah, right there, they got the grab onto MP before the BKB, but with that new Aghanim's picked up by the Centaur, he takes like no damage, so they won't be able to bring him down before he gets it off. But still, BKB's forced, and that was like, that was Secret's like big play to try to go for some kind of comeback to get something.
It really was. I mean, we saw there, it was just the fact that they couldn't get mid one close up and in position to do the damage.
Oh, yeah. Five blinks in all the way to their base.
Oh, and in fact, Anna, he goes in even further. They get a three-man vacuum here, and that's mid one out. Immediately buys back. They'll lose Puppy as well. He's out for 45 seconds. No buyback available. And No Tail just dishing out the damage here. He's taking himself a triple kill. Backs away after mid one buys back. And Secret just can't find a kill in return. It really is. I mean, MP does have damage, but it's just not enough to bite through these kind of cores of OG, especially with the auras as well that S4 is able to offer. Jarax.
Oh, he's got the stone, but he gets used up. He's going to get the kick off before.
Oh,
he does get him out of this.
Oh, he just kicked mid one all the way away from his own, and mid one's out, and that may have just sealed the game. Mid one's down for 100 seconds. And this is dieback on the sniper. What can Secret do here, really? They're brought back on the Ogre. Puppy will be back up in 5 seconds. But no Kezia for 20 seconds. No mid one for 90. Tier 4's down. And they're looking for more OG. Anna immediately in onto the Weaver. MP's out as well. Ogre using himself up. But they're going to be losing Puppy and Pylite die. Anna zipping into the base trying to finish off the bounty. And he'll get it as well. Anna beyond godlike.
Jack puts him back in.
Oh dear, GG is called an OG.
Oh, he actually gets on a bit before, but there he goes.
It's already over. 38 to 19. We ain't counting that last kill. He came out and GG came out. That was a BM kill.
Jarex kills his own teammate, but yeah, wow.
But, well, I mean, pretty much, I guess kind of what the panel was saying as well. You know, we know that OG is a team that...